Us a wonderful guest today. We are in the home of Prophet Jill Austin, who the Lord has used in a mighty way and a wonderful way. In fact, I'm going to quote a quote from Pastor Mike Connell of Christian Outreach Center in Hastings, New Zealand. This is a quote from his opinion of a meeting that she held recently in New Zealand. What year was this?
It was this year.
This year?
About 6 weeks ago.
1993, mm-hmm. For those of you watching. Here is his quote, what Pastor Mike Connell says. At times, the Holy Spirit swept over the congregation, healing and releasing people from grief, bondages, and demonic forces. Woo! At other times, people were touched with great joy. I know what that is. That's being drunk in the Spirit. And with deep repentance and weeping in intercessory prayer for souls. On several occasions, dozens of people fell down simultaneously as waves of the power of God swept over segments of the congregation. The power of God so filled the auditorium that even people at the rear of the crowd of over 900 people fell down. Many times Jill moved out in personal prophetic ministry with considerable accuracy. You know, that's the Holy Spirit. Amen. Welcome, Jill Austin,
Thank you.
And evangelist for the Lord, missionary. You finally got to be one.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for taking time today for you out there watching. And what would you say that the Holy Spirit is doing today?
I feel that the Lord is just coming with such fresh waves of His Holy Spirit. And when I was recently in New Zealand, it was such an exciting time. I did 5 different conferences there, and each of them were 3 or 4 days long of around 1,000 people. But what was so exciting was the hunger, the vulnerability, the people just crying out and saying, I want God. And New Zealand, their background is their English. And you would think they were very conservative, but they're really not. They've got that pioneer heart and that pioneer zealousness that wants the Lord. And often I would just see the power of the Holy Spirit just come and release fresh fire, just like it says in Joel, it says, I will pour out my spirit on all flesh, and my sons and my daughters will prophesy, and my old men will dream dreams, and my young men will see visions.
Would you say that this was all a Christian gathering of churches, or was it people that were Christians and they brought people that weren't Christians, a mixture? Or,
you know, I feel that this was this meeting we're talking about here was a leadership meeting, and it was with the COC Churches, which is Christian Outreach Center, and it's throughout a lot of different nations in the world, and they had about 900 pastors and wives and leaders there, and it was a 3-day conference, and the COCs, they move prophetically, they move with deliverance, but their heart was as they wanted revival. They wanted to just see the power and the presence of God move. It was, you know, like when we see the prophetic, I think that we get comfortable, Susan, with different kinds of the school of the prophetic, where we can have people stand up and we can give them a prophetic word, or we can have a person come forward and 3 or 4 prophetic people can give them a word like a presbytery. But there's something about the sovereignty of the Holy Spirit. Where, you know, all of a sudden you just see waves of God touching people. And I mean, it's exciting if we can lay hands on people and pray for each one. But when you start getting into crowds of hundreds and hundreds,
there's no way you
there's
can.
There's no way.
No way, Jose.
And you've got to just trust that God can sovereignly touch people.
Yes.
And when the fire of God comes, it connects the head to the heart. Mm-hmm. It changes you. Mm-hmm. It changes you in how you think and how you feel. All of a sudden, it's not just logos, the written word of God, it's rhema. Mm-hmm. The word of God has life. The word has a fire to it. There's a fresh hunger. And mm-hmm. I feel that God wants to pour out fresh hunger and mm-hmm. fresh fire. And that in the charismatic churches, the Pentecostal churches, mm-hmm. I think that we're starting to fall short of the glory of God.
Ooh, wow.
How'd you like that?
Starting to fall short of the glory of God.
Well, Susan, I feel that we've gotten into a pattern, almost a formula,
yes.
And I minister in churches all over, and mm-hmm. I love the body of Christ.
Mm-hmm.
But we talk about getting baptized in the Holy Spirit, mm-hmm. and that you speak in tongues, and that's it. Why, in Acts 2, it said that fresh fire fell on all 120 people, the men and the women,
uh-huh.
and they came out as they were drunk, and then 3,000 mm-hmm. people were added that day. But then in Acts 4, it says the power of the Holy Spirit came again. And what came is there was a boldness. And I feel that God wants us to move with that Elijah anointing.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And that Elijah anointing, they were a company mm-hmm. of people that had the fire of God. And that they were people who could intercede and pray. That they had mm-hmm. enough hunger that they could pray. And they could, by the unction of the Lord, that it wouldn't rain. And that mm-hmm. the fire of God would come and ignite mm-hmm. the altars, that the idolatry in our own lives and other people, mm-hmm. and that we need to be a prophetic people where we're full of fresh fire and fresh mm-hmm. hunger for the things of the Lord.
I feel in my spirit there are ministers watching right now that want to tap into this, and they want their church to be ignited. They want their fellowship, whether it be 50 people or 500 people, to be ignited. Would you address that?
You know, Susan, what was so exciting was that Pastor Mike Connor in New Zealand,
mm-hmm.
what happened was when he picked me up at the airport in Hastings, I've been to New Zealand 5 times now,
mm-hmm.
and the last several times, it's been like an open heaven where there's mm-hmm. just been a sovereign outpouring of God, where people will be laughing for hours and crying for hours, and
mm-hmm.
Miraculous healings, and families healed, relationships
mm-hmm.
healed, unity with the churches working together.
Mm-hmm.
And what I found was is that with Pastor Mike, when he asked me to come and speak at their leadership conference,
mm-hmm.
Whenever you have the fire and the anointing of God,
mm-hmm.
It's also controversial. I mean, you get people who love the fire of God, but it also stirs up a lot of religious spirits. And many mm-hmm. of the churches, like the Quakers, and mm-hmm. the reason they were called Quakers was they quaked. And the reason they were called Shakers was because they shook. But after 10 or 20 years, what happens is a lot of the fire starts to mm-hmm. lift, and
mm-hmm.
we start to put the Holy Spirit in a back room, and we
mm-hmm.
get more conservative. And
mm-hmm.
Instead of just having that fresh wind of
yes.
the free spirit of the Holy Spirit, and it is messy and it's controversial. So
mm-hmm.
when I went to the city, I've heard a lot of reports.
Mm-hmm.
And he says, it seems like the people who have had you before, they
mm-hmm.
love you.
Mm-hmm.
But then we got controversial reports, and he says, most of those people, they'd never seen you. And he says, I just know that I want God.
Mm-hmm.
And he
didn't care what the cost.
And he didn't care about the price
uh-uh.
behind the anointing.
That's right.
And what I would say to pastors
mm-hmm.
that are listening is there's a price behind the anointing,
mm-hmm.
and that the Lord is saying, let my people go.
Mm-hmm.
Let me have my church.
That's good.
He says, will you let me come and bring fresh fire,
mm-hmm.
fresh revival,
mm-hmm.
a fresh touch of my hunger?
Mm-hmm.
And so what I found with Mike was Mike had just moved into a warehouse that had been redone, and
mm-hmm.
But once again, there was a test.
Mm-hmm.
And the test was, will you let me come?
Mm.
And I feel that it's not just come, Holy Spirit.
Mm-hmm.
It should be stay, Holy Spirit.
Yes.
That we should say, Lord, we want you to come.
Yes.
What would we do without you? And yes, it's a church gathering, and it was a time to ignite people who ministered and known the Lord,
mm-hmm.
to ignite them with a fresh hunger and fire.
Mm-hmm.
And so what happened is when I got there, New Zealand, as you know, is two different islands. It's North and South Island. And the director of the COC churches over the North Island and the South Island had watched a video and seen the power of the Holy Spirit touch a congregation, so they vetoed me coming to speak.
You're kidding.
No. And so what Mike did is he was the president of the nation over both North and South Island, so he vetoed their veto. And he just said, Jill, I want God. He goes, I want revival. So when we did the meeting the first night, there was about 900 people there, and I met the international president of the COCs, Neil Myers, and he had also heard controversial things. But once the power of the Holy Spirit came, the people were laughing and crying, and I asked the people to get in the different aisles, and there probably was about 75-100 people in each of the aisles, and you could just see the wind of God coming, and all of them would go down in the Spirit in all the aisles, and hundreds of people were being touched and empowered with fresh hunger. And then the next night there was a heavy deliverance and repentance and heavy intercession and travailing and physical healing. And the last night Pastor Neil got up there and he said, you know, this is revival. He says, I want God. I want to have a fresh touch.
I really feel there are conservative ministers, leaders watching that do not understand this move, this new fresh fire that you call it. How would you explain to them, I mean, I don't even know if we can, but how could we, in a simple way, tell them that this is the genuine move of God and not sensationalism, crowd control, manipulation, emotionalism, all those superficial things that this is not part of. They want the power of God, but they're so stuck in their tradition, their way that they've done church for years, that this is the way they understand God. They're comfortable that way, even, but they've heard about this new move and they want to be part of it.
Well, first of all, it's not a new move. It's an old move.
Give me that old-time religion.
That old-time revival that with Acts 2, the power and the fire of the Holy Spirit came. And the people then thought they were drunk. And I think that, you know, I really feel that when you have a power encounter with the Holy Spirit, one reason that people shake and tremble, it's like we are earthenware vessels. And 2 Chronicles 4, it says that we're earthenware vessels, and the treasure in us, that is the glory, that is Jesus Christ. And sometimes when the reason people shake and tremble is it's like they plug their finger into heaven's light socket and they tremble.
Good. That's right, that's right.
And also when the fire of God comes, it does many different things. I think that that's one reason why the pastors feel out of control. And you know, it says like, let's have everything in decency and order, but it's divine order.
Amen.
And that we need to let God come. And I think that when the fire of the Lord comes,
He is in order.
He is in order.